being here. Our next piece fits into the part of our curriculum which I call the slow, smooth, best tone quality part of our curriculum. So we're working in this piece on developing our very best sound and controlling it from as quiet as we can play to pretty much as loud as we can play. So, and it's also just a really beautiful piece of music. It's called Clouds. Same composer, Timothy Broge, and they're both what musicologists would put in the category of program music, which is basically music that's supposed to tell a specific story. Like the previous piece we played had a generic story of creating sort of mental pictures of clouds. The first one doesn't really follow a specific story. You could kind of make up your own if you wanted, but the next two are called Train Heading West and The Headless Horseman, and both of them are really supposed to evoke specific images in your head when you hear them. So see if you can kind of get a sense of what each one is about. If we do it right, hopefully you should. Transcription, which means it's a piece, it's actually a piece originally written for piano. The most famous version, they took the piano version and turned it into a full orchestra piece. And then this is an adaptation of the full orchestra piece for band. And the original has, it's the story of the composer walking through a museum. And the first music you hear is what he heard in his head just as he was walking. And then he gets to these different paintings. And the two ones portrayed in the version we're doing are what's called the Hut of Baba Yaga, which is kind of like a Russian interpretation of Hansel and Gretel's house, but it's on these very terrifying tall chicken legs. And you'll kind of hear that spot. It'll be obvious when we get to the scary music. And then the last part's called the Great Gate of Kiev, which is just, it's a very large painting of the very noble, important gate that goes into the city of Kiev. Mussorgsky was a Russian composer, so this is kind of part of his national heritage.
Thank you. Thank you. chorus director here at the Ahern for 5th through 8th grades. I'm new this year, so I'm a new face for most of you. And I'll have the 8th graders announce the songs that they're singing, so I won't say too much about the program, but I will say that I feel like we've come a long way just since September, and it's been a joy to work with your mostly daughters, a couple of sons. We're just waiting for a couple of band members to join us. And we hope you stay too for the junior jazz band following the chorus program.
Original words and music by John Lennon and Paul McCartney. This version includes singing canon, singing harmony, and singing different signatures. It also includes Mr. Haggerty on acoustic guitar.
Thank you.
Presidential elections.
It is a song of hope and a call to everyone to stand up for peace, justice, and equality. It reminds us that if we all do our part, we can be heroes and we can change the world.
Thank you. Chances by soloing for you. First we heard Dominic D'Amico, and you're going to hear from him again today, right now. We heard from Ken Eva and Kayla Prag on flute, and I should just say the first names, on piano, and finally Corey Hall on drums. Thank you. Many of you might know that Mr. Massey and I spent some time this summer in Australia working with a group of students at a private school in Perth, the other side of the world. And when we were there, I introduced them to this song, the kids, and we kind of played it by ear and everything. So they wrote that arrangement, the director there and another friend of his who's also a jazz musician in the area, wrote that arrangement and sent it to us. So that was a gift from them, and I wanted to send them the tape of this. So I'm saying thank you, Martin and Gary, for doing that. All right, this one's called The Ballad for Blue Horn. Yeah. Thank you. And it's a little switch in the program. This one, the program says chameleon, but we'll do that next. This is going to feature Dominic on a ballad. get really excited because they get to bring out their electric stuff. This is a little rock for you. School back down here on Tuesday afternoons, stay till 4:30. Mario lives in Boston, so he has to make a huge commitment, his family and him, and you know, make sure they're here, and he's here every week. It's incredible that the commitment these kids make to do that. And the other high school students, Ken and RJ, provide leadership, and they come in here and they can kind of play lead at the high school band. They're the freshmen, so they're not playing the lead parts yet, and so they might be playing like a third part or a fourth part up there. But here they get to lead the group, major soloists, and it gives them more confidence and it helps the younger students. So it's a great win-win for everybody, so I want to thank them for doing that too. The next piece, I couldn't resist doing this because we do it every year, and we only play it in the cafeteria right before Christmas. We do a calf gig, you know, we have a brunch gig for the students, and we play some music for them. So Jingle Bell Rock, since they learned it, and there's a couple soloists in here that you should hear because they sound great. So we're gonna have you listen to this one, throwback to the holiday season. Section, our bass player in particular, and RJ, so we're going to have some fun with this one.
Thank you. more hand for the 8th grade band. And the choir, the 8th grade band and the choir, they were fabulous. Great job. Thanks, everybody.